Right, I am down at the overflow. Wondering where that frame has fallen from to be on top of there. That's a very right rally frame, that one. 531C needs to be built into something interesting. Rally courier frame. John Darby, you were asking about a red courier for a friend. I will speak to you about that. Anyone who's watched Monkey Shred's latest video, yeah, I've got one just as bad and exactly the same. I need to strip that down. This is going to be an interesting little project as well. A child's doors and that. The head bed is probably worth as much as the rest of the bike, but I don't want to part it really. 16 inch wheels. Just a cute little thing. There's somebody out there for that, I'm sure. Yeah, but things have got piled up. Either fold it. There's a motorbike can here that I'm going to talk to you about. I'm going to make a separate video talking to you about that motorbike can, and one about this Crown Star as well. I need some, I need to put it to the hive mind. Excuse the background gammon. I've just written down on this to have a look at this, and this is what I want to speak to you about today. I acquired this about 10 years ago, I think, and put it back on the road. Well, it was on the road, but it was configured like a hybrid. It had no mud guards, knobbly tyres, mountain bike handlebars, that sort of thing. Not very attractive. And that's a mud guard rubbing. I built it quickly, really, to this spec, and we enjoyed a couple of tweed rides on it, and one other ride, Critical Mass Leicester, that's when it was, in 2010. And it hasn't really done anything since, and it's taking up a lot of room, as tandems do, and I'm wondering what to do with it. The Pashley tandem has now gone. The lovely teal coloured Schauff tandem is staying. That's going to be recommissioned. So that brings me to this one. I'm wondering whether to recommission or whether to move it on. If I move it on, do I take it back to original specification, or do I keep it like I've got it, or do I do something completely different with it? It's 70s or early 80s, probably 80s by the graphics, although I have to confess these graphics are ones that I put on because I painted the bike, but it had something similar before. I just had this set among many other sets in the back of the shop. Right, I'm waffling now. I'm going to talk you through it. It has nice Mafat cantilever brakes. The Peugeot mud guards, and these aren't the ones that it had horrible plastic things on. No, it had no mud guards, that's right. That's how they go. But these are what it would have had, and I had a pair, so they went on. These rear bars are not what would have been on, but it gives the stoker a more upright sitting position. As you can see, it's double lateral, it's called, when you've got these mixty type tubes. Running front to back like that, that's lateral, so that's twin laterals, and then you've got the same here, so you've got double twin lateral, pioneered by a French maker called Narcisse. And this one is a step through rear, so it's a mixed rear, and I find it a rather attractive frame, to be honest. Again, the Mafax on the rear, but in addition to that, excuse the upside down camera, there is an Arai drum brake, which is original fitting. You can see it's got the bracket on the frame for it. In fact, the wheels are original, with the nice concave rims on them, large flange hubs. I fitted the XT Mac for efficiency. It's only got 6 on the rear. It would take 8. No problem there. Right. That's where you've gone. Okay, Christopher Hobbs, who bought my green clod Butler. I found the original front mech, I think. I supplied you with a Mountec, and it wasn't quite right. I found the original. I'll swap you back if you want. TA crank set, very nice indeed. You can see how the outer ring has been ground down to be a guard. So it's 2. It's 2 times 6. And it's got the TA on this side. It has an eccentric bottom bracket. For people who don't know tandems, let me show you. That's what this is. Normal bottom bracket running through an eccentric off-center shell. Underneath, it's clamped. Actually, it's a pair of seat bolt clamps, seat clamps. And you slacken those off. You can turn this part, the outer part, around, which moves the bottom bracket axle forwards or backwards to tension your chain. That's how you keep your chain in tension on a tandem. And these have crept in recently into a lot of adventure bikes and such like that use roll-off hubs and such as that as a way of tensioning those chains as well. This Suntour shift lever was clamped to the stem like that, and that operates that rear brake, the drum brake on the rear. That's called a drag brake. So you pull it on with this with a friction lever, and it just sits there binding to keep your speed down on long downhill descents. And of course, that big disc dissipates the heat. It's something from touring tandems if you're not familiar with those things. I fitted these little extra cyclocross levers. It has handlebars which are too modern in profile, but they work very well, and they're nice and wide for controlling a tandem, and bar end shifters. So it was a nice setup. I don't like drops anymore. My back doesn't like drops. So if I'm keeping it at all, it's going to get upright handlebars. I'm quite tempted though to just recommission it and sell it on, and someone can enjoy it. So would you like to see this as a project? Let me know in the comments, and I'll take it on as a project and do a few videos on it and move it on. Otherwise it'll probably stay in the lockup for a little while longer before I get round to recommissioning it, and if it's not being sold on. Are the rear lights missing? That is a Swiss number plate, which is not part of the bike, it's just an affectation. I've forgotten about this nice rear carrier. I fitted that as well. There's the Peugeot. That's a Peugeot original bracket on the mudguard. So there we are. That's the Peugeot tandem. Could be an exciting project. There could be a lot of teaching in it, a lot of learning in it. I'm just not feeling it for the end product, so unless I hear otherwise, I think it's going to be recommissioned and sold on. Let me know if you're interested. I'll just give you a quick look at the frame as well. Didn't really give you a proper look. But it's quite pretty, to be honest, the frame. That's a protector for locks and such like. Some nice brazing work on it. Some nice lugs. It's just really not looking its best at the moment. Right, in you go. That is just a mudguard catching. How skillful was that, eh? Right, stay safe, see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.